Silence!
A lot of people might be wondering, why are these raised beds going to be so small? I'll tell you why. Now, as far as the dimensions of this raised bed, I decided on this size, even though it seems relatively small, for a couple very good reasons. One, it's very portable. Something like this can easily be lifted up and toted around and put anywhere in your garden. So that's kind of cool. So being small makes these portable, and that's a good thing. Okay, here's my reasoning for the dimensions of this bed. Most garden plants that I know of do not put out a root system wider than 1 foot. You know, if you think about it, how wide do your plants actually put out their roots? Not very wide. These aren't trees. These are one season plants, so they don't really put out that wide of a root base. With this being only 1 foot wide, I have the plants planted right along here, for instance, peppers, carrots, anything like that. As far as carrots, I could probably get away with 2 rows here, which will be really nice. Radishes, anything I want can fit into this box. And I don't have to weed too awful much, and the plant will kind of overhang a little bit and shade it and help keep the weeds down. This, as far as I can plan, is going to mean a lot of less weeding for me. And if it's less weeding, it's got to be a good thing, right? So the width of this is wonderful for not having to weed. It gives it plenty of room for the roots. The depth is 12 inches, and not many plants that I know of are going to send roots down over 12 inches. And plus, if they want to, they can. Now, if they want to put their roots down farther, they can, but generally 12 inches is going to be about as deep as a plant is going to put its roots. I can control the exact amount of compost 12 inches down without having to rototill, which is nice. I don't have to bring a rototiller in here. I can just take a little hand shovel, shovel it up, and get it all ready for planting. Also, the length. You know, like say if I'm planting radishes, I don't really need a truckload of radishes. 2 rows of radishes about 4 inches apart is perfect. So I have 4 inches, 4 inches. I have my radishes perfectly spaced, and this is narrow enough to where the leaves of the radishes are going to shade it and keep it relatively moist and weed free. The length is perfect. I figure 2 rows of radishes in here is more than enough radishes for me. Same thing with the spinach, lettuce, anything I'm going to grow. Peppers. If I grow a row of peppers here, this is going to hold about maybe 6 pepper plants. That's perfect. I'm not going to be planting all of my peppers in here. I'm going to plant, like, say, pepperoncinis in this box. In another box somewhere across the garden, I'm going to plant things like bell peppers or jalapenos. This way they won't cross-pollinate, which will be a good thing, and I can save the seeds from them. So the raised bed has all of these benefits, and as far as I'm concerned, I can't really find any negatives to doing them this way. So it's easier to tote around, it's deep enough for the roots, it's wide enough for the roots, it's small enough to actually contain just what I need of that particular variety. With the corn, I'm going to do them 2 feet wide. And that's really plenty of room for corn. I can actually do 2 rows of corn in a 2 foot wide planter box around 16 feet long. That's going to be fantastic for corn, and like I said, not as much weeding. So this is actually going to be a really good thing. Okay, I got a million other raised beds to get done, but I wanted to show you why I'm doing them so narrow and so short, because I know you're going to have questions about that. Okay, I'm sure you're going to have questions I haven't anticipated, so if you do, toss them in the comment section and I will definitely answer them for you, okay? Let's go on to something else, because I have a lot of things to go over. Before and after. Remember my sock? Well, I couldn't wait any longer, so I decided to wash it. Actually, I'm not washing it. I'm making compost tea, and I'm doing it in my basement. What I do is I just put the compost in here, dump it in a bucket, fill it full of water. Now, one thing I want to make very clear, because there could be a really bad mistake going on, do not use chlorinated water. If your faucet comes with chlorinated water, let the water set for 24 hours. This allows the chlorine to go back into space. I don't know where it goes. It won't be in your water after that. So let your water set for 24 hours to get rid of the chlorine. See, I have 2 wells on my property, so I have well water, which has no chlorine whatsoever, but I also have what's called county well water coming into one of my faucets, so I actually have 3 sources of water, and the stuff that comes into my faucet, I found out is chlorinated. You can tell by the smell. It smells like a swimming pool, which is not a good smell, and that is not good. Now think about it logically. Chlorine is put into your water to do what? Any answers? I know you guys got answers. Yes, it's to kill bacteria. And what are we doing with compost tea? We are getting the nutrients out of it and feeding bacteria to put into our soil, into our plants. Now, bacteria is one thing that your plants cannot live without in the soil. So, if you're putting chlorine in your compost tea, you're killing all the bacteria. You're basically sterilizing, because chlorine, think of it as Clorox, bleach. It's similar to that, okay? Chlorine is gonna kill the bacteria in there, and it's really not gonna do a heck of a lot of good for your plants. It won't kill them, probably, but it isn't gonna be as good as non-chlorinated water. So, all you have to do is let your water set for 24 hours. I just used water from my dehumidifier in the basement. I have that running because it's been very rainy and the basement gets a little damp. So I run the dehumidifier, it fills up with water, and I put it in here. So it's free water for me. All I do is I toss this thing in there, let it set for 24 hours, and then I come by and I just spill it on myself and squeeze the sock, toss it back in there, and I have, it looks like chocolate milk. Okay, and this is what it looks like when it's done. It's just, I don't know, 2 cups of compost in a 5-gallon bucket, and I get this brown looking stuff, and there's really no smell to it at all. Actually, there is no smell whatsoever. And this is what I've been watering my plants with. Remember I planted the 2 tomatoes and the 3 peppers? Well, one of the tomatoes, the soil was a little bit light colored, and I didn't know why. Apparently that was a kind of nutrient free soil. There was nothing in it, and the bottom leaves started turning yellow really quick. You've done that before? You planted a plant and it's outside, you're all happy, you plant your plant, and you notice the bottom leaves start turning a little bit yellow. They're going through a little bit of a stress period and they're trying to adapt, and then sometimes there just isn't enough in the soil, or the roots are damaged, or something's going on. It could be a myriad of reasons, but one way to give it the best shot is to not overwater it, but give it compost tea when you water it. This will give it the nitrogen, the nutrients, and help feed the plant, so there's a lot less on your list of things that could be going wrong. Make sure, if your plants start turning light colored, give them compost tea, it'll darken them up nicely. And that's what it did. Here's my compost tea. I gotta be careful because I keep dropping it in there and it splashes, and I'm usually not wearing shorts and it gets all over my pants. And the last thing I need is doo-doo water all over my clothes, because this compost was made with chicken manure and straw. So it is basically doo-doo water. So Ray's playing with doo-doo water in the basement. Okay, so I wanted to show you really quick this bucket of compost tea. I'm using it indoors and outdoors. Cool thing is, with just a small amount of compost, let me show you how much it is. It's literally maybe a heaping cup of compost, maybe 2 cups of compost. Throw it in a 5-gallon bucket in a sock. You can fill this thing up about maybe 3 times with water and squeeze out the good stuff in the compost. That's a lot. 15 gallons of compost tea out of 2 cups of compost. I think that's pretty good. And then when I'm done, I'm going to cut this sock open and throw the used up compost in one of my plants, and voila, I got extra soil. So nothing is going to waste with this stuff, with my bag of tea. No molasses, no bubbler, none of that crap. I don't subscribe to that. I don't do that. I mean, it works. A lot of people will do that. I do it the most simple way that I can, because I really don't have time to be doing all of that stuff. So I just soak the compost, use the compost tea in my plants, and that's the wonder that is my garden. I want to show you something up close, okay? I have an update on the pineapple. Remember the big old honking? Well, you can't forget it. It's right here. Let me bring you up close. I got to show you something that's going on, and it really kind of surprised me. Check it out. It's doing great, isn't it? It's the cutest little thing. It's my little porcupine. Now, do you notice something different about this pineapple? Yep. It's putting out flowers on the sides of it. I had no idea. I don't know what I was thinking or what I wasn't thinking, but I forgot these things actually put out flowers. I assumed it would put out a flower and then produce a pineapple, right? I mean, it made sense to me. Apparently, no. It puts out the pineapple, and all of these little things on the side of the pineapple that you see at the store, you know, those little bumps, those were once flowers. Check it out. Little purple flower right there. And from what I understand, hummingbirds will pollinate these. I tried pollinating them and I don't think I did any good, but I really wasn't after it for the seeds. I just wanted to grow the pineapple to fruition and get fruit from it, and that's exactly what I got. It's not very big. I mean, come on. See? It's not very big. But who cares? It's a pineapple. And it's growing in a basement underneath a fluorescent fixture. Well, that was fun. I had to come outside to end the video because today is breezy, it's sunny, it's just, I don't know, it's just a beautiful day and I wanted to share it with you. The garden is in the background, but actually the little tiny garden that I started, but it's going to get better with those raised beds. Next year is going to be the most amazing garden I've ever had. Okay, so maybe I shouldn't have sat in the shade. I should have been in the sunshine because the mosquitoes tend to bite me less in the sun. But I wanted to have this well as a backdrop because I really like this thing. Okay, I gotta go. I got things to do, and I hope you're having a great week. I am having a fantastic week. Thanks for joining me. I really do appreciate it. Take care, and I'll talk to you soon. Wow. Ah, mosquito. Oh. Yeah. Oh. Okay, so maybe I shouldn't have sat in the shade.